Hi, my name's Sherry Smith. I'm part of the Look and Don't Forget project, which is to raise awareness of Roma genocide. This year, we couldn't be in Poland, we couldn't be in Krakow with Dikanowista, so this year we're doing an online live event. We've got a 2.5 hour live event on the 2nd of August, but as part of that, we've also created a YouTube channel with lots of content from different supporters and community members that show solidarity. Today, I'm talking to author Ruth Barnett, and she's going to be talking to us about one of her books. So I won't talk anymore. I'll hand you over to Ruth.
Thank you. I'm Ruth Barnett, and I was born in Berlin, and I came with my brother on the Kindertransport. It wasn't easy through three foster families and a hostel, but I was treated decently. I didn't meet any hostility. I think children were... I've been able to make good, and I'm very concerned about the amount of hostility, particularly towards Roma Gypsy travellers. It seems to be well understood that it's wrong to insult other ethnic minority groups, but it's okay to do what you like against the gypsies. And I think this is awful. I've been fighting it ever since Dale Farm came under threat. I supported Dale Farm right through about a 10-year process. And I've been involved in Holocaust education for a good 20 plus years. And I was one of the few people who argued from the beginning against making the Holocaust narrative a Jewish only story. It was much more than a Jewish story. And I bitterly opposed the wiping out of the Roma who were in just about all the concentration camps, ghettos and killing fields with the Jews, sometimes even in the same barracks. And I wanted people to know. Now, the first book I ever wrote was a school textbook on child development. And then I wrote an autobiography, Person of No Nationality, particularly for schools, because I couldn't tell my story in the time that they gave me in enough detail. And then I decided to challenge the stereotypes that most people have in their minds still of what a Jew is and what a gypsy is. So I wrote this book, Jews and Gypsies, Myths and Reality, which is available on Amazon. And in it, I exposed all the ridiculous stories about Jews and gypsies and challenged people to think of every human being being an equal member of the human race. I actually wrote another book, which I donated to the Holocaust Center in Laxton, with the title Quality and Inequality, The Value of Life. But I challenge people with this cover. I don't know whether you can see, it's an outline of a human being filled with thousands of tiny photos of human beings, to challenge people to think of the whole human race as one person. And each of us is a cell of this one person. And we've got such a lot of cells that are pathologically ill. I see the human race as having many pathological illnesses, but racism as a very serious one. And I challenge it wherever I can go. And ever since I got to know quite a few travelers, Roma, gypsies, personally, when I started supporting Dale Farm, I I can see through the stereotypes. I can see how the stereotypes grew up and how this has got to be challenged, particularly challenged with the government to provide. The government is responsible to provide for the needs of the travelling community as much as the settled community, but they just don't seem to get it. And I think it's enormously important, been attending on August the 2nd for many years, and I've reached the Jewish community in sympathy with another minority that is equally persecuted. And I'm delighted that the Jewish community actually has taken this to heart and is currently supporting the awful treatment of the Uyghur by China. And I would challenge the Roma Gypsy traveller community to do likewise, to take an interest in other minorities that are coming in for unacceptable treatment. And the loss of the Holocaust and other genocides before and after it are a loss to the whole of humanity. And humanity should be aware and should pay a little respect on August the 2nd and do a bit of active learning, moving from passive bystanders to active upstanders in the whole year round in between. That is my message to people to think about.